Hi, for those who've been following me on Twitter, which is where I post all my dumpster find photos and stuff like that, you would have seen recently how the dumpster room was absolutely chock-a-block. It was nuts because everyone's moving out all at once. It was absolutely crazy, but it's now empty. But check out what's turned up today. A crappy printer, which I won't take, a few old monitors. But we have a Dell monitor that was like a 24 inch, pretty decent, but it looks like we have a all-in-one PC, Dell all-in-one PC. So, damn, I'm scoring both of those. Take it back. Let's go back to the lab. I brought my bin down, that's my tiny little bin there, because I was just emptying it out and score. Yeah, okay, everyone's screaming at me, Dave, that's not an all-in-one PC, and yep, I've been diddled. I was absolutely fooled because of the form factor of the thing, the fact that it's, you know, it's got the speakers down the bottom, the big part here, and obviously the stand like this, which makes it, which means like it's a touch screen, and you know, I just didn't look at all the bits down there. It just, you know, where's the Ethernets and all the other stuff. Yep, you guessed it, this is, you can probably get the model number down there for those playing along at home. Anyway, I think it's the 2221T. Yes, it is a touch machine, but it is not, unfortunately, an all-in-one PC, which I've found in the dumpster before. But, you know, it's got all the USBs and things like that. But, yeah, it is a touchscreen. Apparently, it's an optical touchscreen. Not like capacitive touch rubbish or resistive touch rubbish. No, optical, which is probably why it has, if you have a look down there, quite a significant thickness. It looks like, oh yeah, I really have to clean this sucker up. But down in there, so obviously they've got an array of optical, you know, LEDs and, you know, probably infrared LEDs and photo transistors in the side of the thing, and it's a touch screen. Apparently Windows 7 plug and play compatible, so it doesn't mention anything higher than that, but yeah, let's see if it works. Plug that in. No Bangsky. Oh, hello. There it is. Dell ST2220T. So it is the touch model. Apparently, like, it does come in a regular non-touch model, which has doesn't have the stand, the tilt stand like this one does. But that looks like it works a treat. Where's the menu button? There you go. No whackers. Yeah, that's fine. As with virtually all the monitors I find, oh yeah, no, you can't, yeah, you can't operate the menus with the touch. So yeah, it's obviously you just got to go to the Windows system. They didn't bother implementing that internally. I don't blame them. It's all too hard. So that works. Try out the touch, but let's try the other monitor. So I've, of course, given away a whole bunch of monitors. I once gave away 15 of them that I found in the dumpster. I was collecting them. And I gave away 15 to, like, a kid's, you know, like a disadvantaged kids thing or something like that. So that was really cool. Anyway, this one has the USB inputs, and it has HDMI and DisplayPort and VGA. Thank you very much. And it looks like, oh, it's still got the sticker on it. Look. Look, oh, beautiful. Thankfully, it's got IEC connection. None of that plug pack rubbish. I hate those, but this looks pretty modern. So what is it, a 20? That looks like it's probably a 24 jobby. Yes, my arcade machine is on. Where's the damn buttons on this thing? Under here, there we go. Dell, of course it works. Oh, this one, like, you know, it's bezel-less, like, you know, frameless or whatever you call them, goes right to the edge. That seems to, yep, Dell 24 monitor, 24 inch. It's a P2419H. No whackers, no DisplayPort cable. So, yep, but as I expect with all these monitors, they just work. No problem whatsoever. So that's a score. Let's go back to the touchscreen, try that out. You little bloody ripper, check it out. It works just fine and dandy. Look at this. Ah, fantastic. Wow, pretty darn happy with that. But I need to get the touchy screen, so I need to put Windows in tablet mode or whatever that is. Not sure how to do that on the desktop here. Is that even possible? How do I get up my keyboard thing? Yeah. But anyway, that's fantastic. Of course, I do prefer a proper keyboard and mouse, but like on a bench like this, especially if you got like, you know, real estate's valuable, then it can be handy to have a touchscreen monitor like this. And it's full HD, so no worries. This is going to be a nice addition to the lab. I just got to figure out how and where to use it. So winner, winner, chicken dinner. From the dumpster, never fails. It's, you know, just keeps giving. Especially monitors, unbelievable. People just throwing out monitors and a touchscreen monitor like this one. They didn't need it anymore. Yeah, whatever. People are just moving out of offices. They're downsizing. They're doing whatever. They get new computers and they just toss the old ones out. They don't even bother to list them for free on Gumtree or Facebook Marketplace or whatever the stupid thing is. So, yeah, it's just easier to whack them down the dumpster room. So, yeah, as I can attest to trying to give everything away for my lab move cleanup, yeah, it's hard work actually giving stuff away for free. Believe it or not. So anyway, if you liked the video, please give it a big thumbs up. As always, discuss down below. Catch you next time.